Hey guys, let's talk about the Ellis dividing head. Hey everybody, here are all the parts that came with my particular Ellis dividing head that I have acquired off of eBay. And it came with this fixed mounting base. Standard mounting base, fixed mounting base, doesn't allow you to swivel except in this direction. A tailstock, three total plates, plates 1, 2, and 3. And they have a numbering system for the holes for each one of those rings. The actual Ellis dividing head, currently it's mounted on a rotating base that swivels in both directions. It has a three jaw chuck to hold your workpiece. And this index plate that is mounted in it is where the magic happens. You can see that as I rotate this, it rotates your workpiece. You'll see that how this is used in a little more detail later. But usually you leave it fixed in one position or the other. This is horizontal. But you could rotate it up, let's say 20 or 30 degrees and make a bevel gear here. Or you could rotate it the full 90. And there's a mark right here to see where you get to. And that would be in the full 90 degree position. So again, index plate, three jaw chuck, arbor for your workpiece, rotating base, extra plates, tailstock, standard base. If you don't mind, ignore the Wiltons here. We're just filming this on the Wilton table. But the dividing head, you need to do a little bit of math. So the key thing on here is, one, knowing what you want to do. How many divisions do I want to divide a circle into? This chart shows plane indexing, and it shows that there are standard index plates, number 1, 2, and 3. And they're here with their numbers, 1, 2, and 3. 3's seen some age. And what the first chart shows, I have some highlights on here I wanted to describe. These are the prime numbers. So all the prime numbers in sequence, you can divide a 360 degree circle into all these prime numbers all the way up to 47 with these first three plates. Now, my kit didn't come with chart number 2's plates, which are plates 4, 5, 6, 7. I don't know that I'd ever need them either, but it carries on where this one left off as far as primes go, and it starts with 53 and carries on all the way up through 97. So all the primes all the way up through 97 if you have both sets of plates. So what are the real possibilities with this device? Well, first of all, you could put on an arbor a round piece in your Bridgeport and machine something that's six-sided. So divide it by six right there. And you can do this by rotating the wheel or by direct indexing. So here's a direct indexing plate. If you can see right in that narrow passage there. And the cool thing about that is it's set up, and the number of divisions here are 12, just like a clock. So it gives you those common 30, 60, 90 degree angles you need to do things like this simply. But if you want to do something a little more complex, like divide a circle into 14 parts, what you do is you come to the chart, number of divisions column, and the 14 for 14 tooth gear or 14 parts means you need to use the index circle 21, which is on plate number 2 right there, and you need to rotate twice and add 18 holes. So I'll go through and explain this, but let me keep going down the chart. This is how many turns, index turns, so many turns up here for the small gears to make your divisions. And then all of a sudden it goes down here to 1. And then once you get to the end of the first column, if you notice there's 4 columns. Once you get to these bottom rows, you find out that you don't even need to rotate the wheel an entire rotation. You just need to rotate it a certain number of crank holes. And I'll explain this later, but that's why there's only this first segment has 4 columns. All the others have 3. So this means you rotate many times around the wheel here, but on the other ones you just rotate partially to get to your division that you need to get to. So let's put it together, and we're going to do a 14 divisions, so we're going to use plate number 2. Dividing a circle has been very important historically in a machine shop to enable different gears to be made, or in the case in the 1700s for a guy named Jesse Ramsden to be able to know what a degree was so he could mark wheels and navigational instruments. I'm gonna get everything lined up. Bushing supplies just the right amount of tension. And then I think 21 was the second one down. We'll look here in a second and see. So now that we've put the number 2 plate in, we have everything all set up to make divide our circle into 14 parts. We have the right plate, we have the right setup here, and so these wings are not going to work in their standard fashion, but it's still workable. So I'll show you the odd case. But back to the chart one more time. Henley and Ramsden were really important guys in the Industrial Revolution. So these are the first guys that get in the written record in the history books. They were more associated with tool building for nautical purposes and clocks and machine tools than necessarily for this type of indexing head, which is built for augmenting and making modern tools and standard mills more universal. So let's divide a circle by 14, and we'll see how it works in this odd case. So there are 21 holes going around on this plate, on this inner circle, this very innermost circle, and we're in the top one. It's really hard to see, but it's imprinted 21 right on either side of that hole. The next one up is 23. The next one up is 27, 29, 31, and the outer hole is 33. Really, really hard to see. The stamping's kind of worn. So there's 21 holes in this outer ring that divide a circle into 21 parts. So we're going to use, you know, the table here has done all the math for you and the fractions. It's real simple math, but let's execute what's already in the table to make one division of 14. So it says 2 full rotations, so here's 1, you see this is moving, and then 2, back to the beginning, and then 18 holes. So I rotated all the way around, and that's the 18th hole right there. Normally these would be close together so you could spin them both, but there's no room to completely collapse them. So that's what we're stuck with. So that's 1/14th of a turn right there. Over here, let's put it on the mill. We just happen to have one outside here. And let's kind of mount it how we use it. So, as you recall, we were doing our indexing, plate,
making these 14 divisions. And basically there'd be a cutter in the mill right here spinning. And with our workpiece in the chuck, we could come back across, or we could mill a flat across like that nut, for example, and then make another rotation of the work,
and then do some more milling, whether you're going to do it longitudinally or in this direction across the top. So the possibilities for dividing a circle with just three plates into as many as 360 different segments, and using that to make all sorts of geometric shapes, gears, bulkheads, other custom pieces, etc.